Here on the screen, you can see our output, that is, we call it as a star pyramid. So in this video, we are going to learn how to write program to get this kind of output. So before we switch on to the program, I want to tell you that what is the concept behind this program, and then we will write the code for this output. So let's move to the concept behind this program. Here you can see that this is the structure of the output which I have shown you just now on the screen. Now this is also divided into number of rows and columns. So as you know that our first loop, that will be for number of rows, as I had told you in my previous video also. So here this number of rows, this will depend upon you. If you want to print 4 rows, 5 rows, that is totally upon you. So in this program we are going to make 5 rows. So here this I, we will take a variable I or any other variable you can take, but the first loop, that will be for creating number of rows. So here you can see that there are 5 rows, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now there is one thing, one very important thing. As you can see that in each row there are some blank spaces also there. For instance, in the first row you can see that there are 4 blank spaces. In the second row, you can see there are 3 blank spaces. Similarly, in the third row, you have 2. And in fourth row, you have only single blank space. Now, how do we get this number of blank spaces? We have to create a relation to obtain this number of blank spaces. So here, when we try to understand or when you try to formulate this, you will find out that number of blank spaces is equal to total number of rows minus the current row number. For instance, over here the current row number is 1 and total number of rows is 5. Here we can see that there are 5 rows. So how many spaces are here? Here there are number of rows minus current row number, so that is 5 minus 1. So here you can see that there are 4 blank spaces. This is 1, 2, 3, and 4. Similarly, when I equal to 2, means when we are talking about row number 2, then number of blank spaces will be equal to total number of rows, that is 5, minus the current row number. So current row number is over here 2, so we have 5 minus 2, that is equal to 3 blank spaces. Similarly, we will have 2 for here, then 1, and when value of I becomes 5, then you can see that there is no blank space because 5 minus 5 is equal to 0. So there is no blank space for this fifth row. So this is the formula to find out number of spaces, to allot number of spaces, that is number of rows minus current row number. Similarly, we have one more thing, that is for number of stars. How many number of stars are to be printed in each row? For that we have this formula. So let's try to understand here. When row number is 1, the number of star is equal to 2 into row number, current row number, minus 1. So when I is equal to 1, number of stars will be equal to 2 into 1 minus 1. So that is equal to only 1 star. When the value of I is 2, means when we are having, when we are working for the second row number, then the number of stars will be equal to 2 into 2 minus 1. So that is equal to 4 minus 1. So that we are having 3 stars over here. Similarly, for row number 3, we have 2 into current row number, that is equal to 3. To 2 into 3 is 6 minus 1. So that is equal to 5 stars. So this is how we are printing this number of stars. So in this program, we have to do 3 things. For that only we will take 3 variables in this program. First one will be to print number of rows. So first variable we will take for number of rows. Second variable we will take to print number of this blank spaces. And the third variable we will take to print the number of stars in each row. So this is the main concept behind this pyramid program. So now let's move to the code part. Let's see how to write code for this kind of program. So this is a star pyramid, so we can create a class name as star pyramid, or this is totally upon you, whatever name you want you can give. So this is a star pyramid, okay. open the editor, delete this. Now in this program we are not going to accept, if you want you can take, for instance, suppose if you want to specify the number of rows you want in your program, so that you can take by taking a new variable. But in this program I'm going to specify the number of rows in the program itself. So public class star pyramid, then public static void main string args. Now we have to take three variables. As I told you, we need three variables, one for number of rows, second for number of spaces, and third for printing the number of stars. So we have taken these three variables. Now we will make the number of rows. For instance, in this program we have five rows, so initially we will take I equal to 5, then I plus plus. Now the second thing which we are going to do inside this for loop, we are going to print the number of spaces. So for that we will work with variable j, j equals to 1, j less than equal to 5 minus I, because the total number of rows which we are having over here is 5. So here if you take any other variable and you want to accept that value from the user during runtime, so you can do that also. So for that, in that case you will take any variable over here. For instance, suppose you take x, then here you will write down x minus I, because there x will be the number of total number of rows and this I is the current row number. Then I j plus plus. So this is going to print, or this is going to provide number of blank spaces. So system dot out dot print, and here we provide, this symbol will be providing the blank spaces, the number of blank spaces over here, which is specified in this for loop. So here 4 blank spaces will be created for each column for j equals to 1. In my previous video I told you that this second variable, this works for the number of row columns. So for each column 1 blank space will be created, as I have shown you just now in the picture also. So this j equal to 1 means from the first column to the fourth column this is going to print blank spaces. Now here we don't provide next line, because when first row is, when we are talking about row 1, then there itself blank spaces should be provided. And here if I write down next line, then that will work for the next line, it will not work for the first row. That's why this next line we will provide later on. So this is the work of J is done over here. Next, we will use the k variable, that will be for printing number of stars. So k equals to 1, k less than equal to 2 into I minus 1. Just now I told you what is, how this relation has been formed, 2 into the current row number minus 1. Then k plus plus, and this is going to print the number of stars. So system dot out dot print. Here also we don't provide next line, because we have to work for each row. If I write down next line over here, then you won't get the desired output. So we close the bracket, and now we provide the next line, system dot out dot print ln. So this is for your next line. Now let's close the brackets. Now here let me show you how this program gets executed. When the value of I is 1, so this is going to be from 1 to 5, means from first row to fifth row. So when value of I is 1, this will move to this inner loop. What this inner loop is doing, this is providing the number of blank spaces. So this is going to provide 4 blank spaces in each column. That is for column number 1 to column number 4, because 5 minus I will give you 4. So this is going to provide 4 blank spaces, and then this k, this is going to print the number of stars. For instance, when I's value is 1, then k is going to print. from 1 up to 2 into I minus 1 means how many stars this is going to print. This is going to print 2 into 1 minus 1, that is equal to 1, means from 1 to 1 this is going to print only 1 star. And then when this all these things is done, then this will move to the next line, and now the value of I have become 2. Now let me explain for this row number 2 also. So when I's value is 2, so J is going to print how many blank spaces? This is going to print from 1 up to 5 minus I, means 5 minus 2, that is equal to 3. So this is going to print 3 blank spaces for 3 columns. And what this K will do? This will do, it will print from 1 up to how many number of stars this is going to print? This is going to print 2 into 2, that is 4, minus 1 means 3. So this is going to print 1, 2, 3, means 3 number of stars this is going to print. And then this will move to the next line for next row. So this is how this program gets executed. So we have to close one more bracket over here. So all the brackets are closed. Now we compile this program. And here we can see that there is no syntax error. Close this. And now we will execute this code. So void main. Okay. From here we can go to see the code, to see the output. So this is our output. So this is how we will print the star pyramid. And this is the code for this. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.